Sargon Bacaud is one of the biggest right-wing YouTubers. As I record this video, he has over 869,000 subscribers. So why exactly am I talking about this YouTuber? John Cleese, the member of MultiPython, has posted this on Twitter. "Rubbish. I have never been anti-Christian, but I have been critical of churches that do not follow Christ's teachings. For example, I don't think Christ would have approved of burning people to death, and I have always been extremely skeptical of globalization. Check your facts." To which Sargon Bacaud said, "I think ridiculing Christianity qualifies you as being anti-Christian, because the purpose of ridicule is to make the person ashamed of themselves and appear ridiculous in the eyes of others. You are part of the problem." Before I make the response, we need to define words. When I think about the word anti-Christian, usually I think of a person who openly hates Christians for existing. Usually, it comes in the form of persecution. For example, somebody attacking other Christians because they are Christian. Or somebody that wants to vandalize churches. It requires hatred of an individual for simply existing, and also leads to harm towards that person for being a Christian. When it comes down to criticizing the ideas of church corruption, that is a separate category than somebody just hating Christians. Church corruption can actually manifest itself in many ways. For example, people abusing the tithing system, or the amount of child victims, and different types of misconduct. And criticism of doctrine is the idea of criticizing something based upon what the book says or what the church teaches. For my case, I'm critical of corruption, I'm critical of doctrine, but I don't hate Christians as people. When it comes down to MultiPython, all of the skits that they have done during the 70s was largely criticizing the ideas of church corruption. For example, they criticized the Spanish Inquisition.
Nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition!
For MultiPython and the Holy Grail, they actually had something that was known as the Holy Hand Grenade.
You have the Holy Hand Grenade?
Yes, of course! The Holy Hand Grenade of Antioch. It is one of the sacred relics Brother Maynard carries with him. Brother Maynard, bring up the Holy Hand Grenade!
But the most famous project of them all was actually The Life of Brian. Now keep in mind, when this movie first came out, back in the 1970s, it was very much controversial. The film's themes of religious satire were controversial at the time of its release, drawing accusation of blasphemy and protests from some religious groups. 39 local authorities in the United Kingdom opposed either an outright ban or an X rating. Some countries, including Ireland and Norway, banned its showing, and a few of these, such as Italy, ban lasted over a decade. It was so controversial that there was actually a TV debate between MultiPython and the clergymen.
It's building up the list a bit, but I mean, the problem that we... No, seriously, the problem that we have got is that you think that we're ridiculing Jesus, and we say, sort of sincerely and truthfully, that is certainly not what we intended to do, and I believe that we're not. And I can best answer that, I think, by answering Alvin's question, which is that what were we trying to do? And I think it comes out, it was spelled out perhaps rather too plainly, rather too banally at one point, when he says, make up your own mind, don't let other people tell you. And we would absolutely deny, at least I would, that there was any attempt to say you should not believe in Christ. What we're saying is take a critical view, find out about it, don't just believe because somebody tells you to. Somebody in the pulpit says something, question it, work it out yourself.
You're seriously suggesting that if someone saw that film, say a young kid who knew nothing about the Gospels or about history, that the figure of Christ that would emerge from it, this story of the Incarnation, would be a noble one, would be...
He would have to sort it out for himself. He would have to, for example, work out, I mean, does one accept every word in the Bible? In the Sermon on the Mount, did they get it all right when Mark wrote it down 30 years later?
I mean, the main reason why I'm bringing this up is because I want to say that criticizing the ideas of church corruption is not the same thing as hating Christians as people. As I stated before, Monty Python was actually in a different time period, where punching up at the church was actually a punch up against corruption in comparison to something like today's climate. In today's climate, we'll probably say that whole entire joke, we heard it 1,000 times before. That joke is cringe. But back then, it was a different climate.